Let's now use a third strategy, which is also called the plug-in strategy. What is the meaning of plug-in strategy? We will go ahead, put in a few numbers and figure out what we want to do. So let's get started with the third strategy in data comparison or quantitative comparison for GRE, which is the plug-in strategy. A strategy where you carefully choose the numbers that you might want to substitute. Here is our first example on the plug-in strategy. It's given to you that A is a positive integer. This line above is very important in quantitative comparison questions. They are giving us two quantities to compare, 7 times 1 by 4a and 5 times 1 by 3a. This is not the neatest, nicest of expressions, but then that's the expression that we have been given. What do we do? One way of doing it is, again, you can see that, okay, I can divide something. Let's see what happens if you divide. Quantity A by quantity B would be 7 by 4A divided by 5 by 3A. How much would this be? This would be 7 by 4A into 3A by 5. A got cancelled. You got this as 21 upon 20, which is greater than 1. So you can get the answer using the division method. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible using the division method. Sometimes, if you do not have enough time, there's also a possibility that people might want to substitute an answer. Here it's given that A is a positive integer, so I had the confidence to cancel it. But in the exam, if they do not give this information, this extra piece that A is a positive integer, I can't cancel, then I cannot use a division method. That is when you will use a plug-in strategy. Because here A is a positive integer, division gave you an answer. Just look at the division method and you realize that, hey, here I got lucky, but I might not get lucky all the time. When you do not get so lucky, you will use the plug-in strategy. Where you would say, sir, what would happen if I put A equal to minus 5 or A equal to minus 2? What would happen if I put A equal to 2? And then you will proceed. This, my friends, is a very powerful strategy. Before you decide which number to plug in, you will realize, hey, what is the question that I would like to answer? Here, the question that you had is, can I cancel A? If they tell you it's a positive integer, you have the license to cancel. If they do not tell you, then what you would do is, you will take one positive value, one negative value. Substitute both of them. If you get a contradiction, you can then go ahead and say, hey, I can't get the answer. It's a very powerful method. Let's see how we can use it in some other question. A is a non-negative integer. I will not use the word positive here, it should have been. A is a non-negative integer. 1 by 4a and 1 by 3a, which of them is bigger? This again is a question that requires you to think. Or you can just go ahead and substitute values. If I put a equal to 1, what happens? If I put a equal to 1, this quantity is 1 by 4, this quantity is 1 by 3. Obviously, 1 by 3 is more than 1 by 4. If I put a equal to 2, what happens? This quantity would, on the left hand side, would be 1 by 16. This would be 1 by 9. That would have given you enough evidence to go ahead and mark the answer. Can I do it using the division method? Possibly, yes. But sometimes the division itself might be complicated. For example, in this particular case, when you're dealing with exponents, your division might not be all that straightforward. So this is one example where you would say, sir, just by putting in a few numbers, I can see that quantity B is greater. I am able to do it because they gave me the word non-negative. But wait. There is a twist. Kahani baki hai. What is the twist? When they say the non-negative, the boundary, you should think about, okay, what is the meaning of non-negative? How, in what way is it different from positive? When they say non-negative, A equal to 0 is a positivity. The moment you put A equal to 0, you get both of them are equal. So, can I now say that quantity B is greater? No, you cannot. You need to look at this word non-negative and say, they gave non-negative means that they are now hinting that there is a possibility of a 0. Let me check out. With that hint, if you just plug in that value 0 carefully, you could then realize that the relationship cannot be determined. What is the most important thing that they help you with? They use the word non-negative.